Hello, my name is Edward from Loyverse team, and today we are going to be talking about how to get started with Loyverse POS. So I am going to take you through the process of creating your first Loyverse account, adding items to your store, and making your first sale. Yeah, and after that, we can go to the back office and check the reports. Loyverse POS was developed to work on Android devices and iOS devices. So this means that you can make use of an Android smartphone, an Android tablet, an iPhone, or an iPad. You can download our software from the Android Play Market and the Apple App Store. Because we are making use of an iPad, you will need to download Loyverse POS from the App Store. So the first step you need to take is to go to the App Store and search for Loyverse POS. That would be the first option at the top. So just tap on it and download. Once Loyverse POS has been downloaded, you need to open it and allow notifications. So you are presented with a window here. And this window asks you if you want to register or sign in. Since we are creating our first account, we go to registration. In the registration window, you will be required to put in your email, your password, the name of your business, the country of registration, and after reading the terms of use and privacy policy, you can tick it and continue. Once you have entered everything, tap continue. And you will get a message that says, thank you for registering with Loyverse. Please confirm your email address. So to confirm your email address, you will need to go to your email. After you have registered for the first time, you are going to see this slider. It's just a slider that shows the different Loyverse products. Here we have the point of sale. Here we have the back office and customer display, kitchen display, and dashboard application. So click done. Right here, you have your sales screen. Now, because we do not have any items in our store, you cannot see anything displayed here. All you can see is go to items. So first we need to add our items. Or we go to menu, items, and under items, we can add our items. So the first item we would like to add, for example, let's say we are running a fast food restaurant. So we can add French fries. French fries. Then now, because we do not have any category created, we can leave that there. Sold by each or by weight, we are selling by each. The price of the item is, let's say, 20. And the cost of production is 10. This means that you have a profit of 10. And then we have SKU, we leave the SKU empty the way it is. We have barcode, we are not selling French fries with barcode, so we just leave it that way. We don't want to track our inventory, we just want it that way, the way it is. And select a color or shape for it, or an image if you wish to, and save. So this way I have added my first item. I can go ahead and add other items, so I'm just going to add two other items to the list. Here, the difference here is that I have this item, ice cream, and I want to track it. So in our stock, we have 20 buckets of ice cream. And we can select a color for it and save. Finally, I have added three different items. We have bottle water, and we have 20 of these bottle waters in store. We have French fries, and we have ice cream. So we have added our items and we can make sales now. So we go back to the menu and go to sales. As you can see, the difference now is that we have three items on our sales screen. So let's say a customer comes and wants to buy something. Customer wants to get French fries. Okay, so we tap French fries and it comes to the ticket. He also wants to get ice cream, and we have that here as well. And finally, he wants to get a bottle of water. Finally, we have all the three items on the ticket with a total of 55. And we can charge. Loyverse POS allows you to select the payment method that was used in paying for the items being purchased. Here at the top, we have the cash section, and at the bottom, we have the card. So if you are getting paid in card, you just tap card, or if it's cash, you select the cash you received. For example, in my case, the customer is giving me 70, and yes, that's all. And finally, I can put in the email of the customer in order to send him a receipt. Well, let's put in an email. And then we can send receipts by tapping send receipts. And receipt has been sent to the email of our customer, and proceed to make a new sale. Now, a quick rundown of what we've done. First, we downloaded the POS application, and then we created an account, added items to our store, and finally made our first sales. Okay, so after doing that, you're pretty much good to go. But I need to introduce you to something else that's also equally important. That is your back office. With your back office, you can make general settings in your store. You can create taxes. You can create loyalty points, have a loyalty program. You can manage your employees, manage your inventory, and so many more things. Also, most importantly, you can see your reports, your sales reports. So right now we are going to go to our back office. Back to our sales screen. To go to our back office, you can tap a menu, and here you see back office. You can sign into your back office using any device, as long as you have a browser on that device. That means you can use a computer, you can use an iPad as we did, you can use a tablet or even a smartphone. We recommend you make use of Chrome browser. All you have to do is to open your browser and go to loyverse.com and then sign in. Once you have signed into your back office, you will see your sales summary. So this is a summary of all sales carried out on the POS application. Let's just go through what we have in the back office. When you go to the menu, you see you have reports. Under reports, you have sales by item, sales by category, sales by employees, and so many more. There are so many other options here. These are for customized reports. Also, we have items. In your items, you can see your item list, categories, you know, modifiers, discounts, and so on. Here in the item list, you can actually add new items. As you can see, these are the items that we added before. It's also possible to export your item list, open it in Google Sheets or Excel, add all the items you have in your store, and import it back into the system. Next, we have advanced inventory management. So this gives you more control over your inventory. It is one of our paid features. Also, next we have our employees management. So this is the employee list. Here you can add your employees, and you can control the access rights of each employee. Next, we also have our customer base. In the customer base, you can add the customers that you have. You can export the customer list, add new customers to the list, and import it back into the system. You can export it to Excel or Google Sheets, just like you can do for the items. And finally, we have the settings. In your settings, under general settings, you can manage different features such as shifts, time clock, open tickets, kitchen printers, and so on. And next, you have the billing and subscription. Here you can manage your billings if you would like to. Also, we have the payment type. Here you can specify the payment types that are being used in your business. You have loyalty points as well. In the loyalty points, you can set up bonus system for your customers. here, also taxes. You can manage taxes here. On the receipts, you can decide what information you would like to be displayed on the receipts. Finally, in the stores section, you can add multiple stores if you are a business owner with multiple locations, and also you can manage multiple devices as well. So this means that you can use as many devices as you wish to with the software. The final option here on the menu list is the help center. Under help, we have the help center, community, and live chat support. So you can reach out to our customer support using any of these channels. We have also prepared lots of help articles that can help you get started with Loyverse. All you need to do is to go to help center, and here you have the help center with all the help articles we have prepared for you. I hope, just like me, you have been able to set up your first store and make sales. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to contact our support team. You can also send your questions to our business owners community. Thank you.